Good morning, dear students. Hope you all are fine and preparing for your unit test. So, we have already started doing the revision here through our these videos. And in my previous two videos, we have already revised our two chapters. One chapter of history, the first chapter of history, and the first chapter of geography. So till there we have already revised, and now today we are going the revision of our civics second chapter. So as you know that the first chapter will not come in your exam, so we will revise the civics second chapter. So second chapter is prejudice and discrimination. So this chapter we are going to start today. So first of all, what is prejudice? So prejudice is, we can say, the bad opinion, the wrong opinion that we make about the people, those who are different from us. So when we make a bad opinion about those people, we call it prejudice. Even we don't know those people, then also when we are having a bad opinion, a negative opinion about them, we call it prejudice. So when we come across people who are different from us, so there are the people, when we come across those people who are different from us, we start looking down those people. I am giving one example here. In our country, in India, there are so many states, and each state is having its own language to speak. So suppose in a particular state, the person, those who are the native of a particular state and speaking a particular language, if he starts feeling that his language is the best language and all the other language of our country, of the different states, are very bad, and start creating a negative opinion about the other language, even he doesn't know those languages, he is not able to understand those languages, if he create a negative opinion about those languages, it is called prejudice. Okay, next is stereotype. So this stereotype comes due to prejudice. That means when we make a negative opinion about, a negative image about of a particular group of people, and put all those group of people into that image, this is called stereotype. Okay, this problem is caused by prejudice only. So due to this prejudice, when we make a negative opinion about, negative image about of a particular group of people and put all those group people into that image, it is called stereotype. So I am giving you one example here, that it is generally said that girls can't drive the bus. Okay, for the girls it is difficult to drive the bus. So it is a negative opinion about the girls, that girls can't do this work. But now in these days we know there are many girls, those who are driving the buses, those who are the drivers and driving the buses in Maharashtra and many other states, there are the girls, those who are driving the buses. So we can say this opinion, this stereotype behavior about the girls, that they can't drive the bus, this is wrong. Okay, so when we say girls can't do this, this is our stereotype behavior about the girl, towards the girl. Now the same example we can take for the boys too, that we think that boys can't do the household chores. That means they are not good in doing the household work. But now in these days we can see there are many people, there are many boys, those who are helping the ladies at home to complete the household work, and they are sharing even the work there with the girls in the houses. So in this way, now this stereotype opinion is also proved wrong by the boys. So not only the girls, but about the boys also, if we are creating any stereotype image, so this creation of the stereotype image is wrong. Next is here our diversity and discrimination. Diversity, you know that our India, there are so, when we divide the people on the basis of religion, caste, color, this is called diversity. Okay, and not only that, but in our country there are so many people, those who are having their own culture, those who are living in different states having their own language, so all these comes under diversity. But when we start discriminating these people on the basis of this diversity, like on the basis of their caste, on the basis of their color, on the basis of their state, even we discriminate people on the basis of the state they belong to. So this all comes under diversity and discrimination. So let us see the types of diversity here where we discriminate the people. So first of all, caste system. In our country we know that we are having the caste system. There are the people, those who belong to upper caste, and there are the people, those who belong to lower caste. So here in our country, now it is not like that, but our constitution, they have provided so many privileges given to the lower caste group people. But previously it was like that, the people of the lower caste, they were treated very badly. Even not only that, they were not even allowed to go to the villages of the upper caste people. They were not allowed to drink the water from the same well. They were not allowed to go to the temples. So all, they were having so many restrictions here in our society. But now in these days, our constitution, the constitution has made many laws to protect these people against the discrimination. So this is the discrimination on the basis of caste system. Next is discrimination, apartheid. So apartheid is discrimination on the basis of the skin color. Okay, so when we discriminate the people on the basis of their skin color, that means the white people and the black people, this is called apartheid. So this was actually practiced many years back in Africa. So in South Africa, many years back, it happened that some of the white people, they were governing the majority of the black people, and they put so many discriminations, so many bans to the people, black people, that they even couldn't go to the places where the white people were going. They were not even allowed to travel in the same compartment with the white people. So this type of discrimination was done in mainly in South Africa. So the Nelson Mandela, he was the leader of African National Congress. So due to his efforts, so this apartheid, this system of apartheid, it was abolished from South Africa. Now here the next one is inequality and discrimination. That means discriminating people on the basis of their economic status. Means discriminating people on the basis of their wealth. Rich people and the poor people. So when more facilities are given to the rich people and less facilities are given to the poor people, this is, we are discriminating the people on the basis of their wealth. So this is also a kind of, you can say, the discrimination that prevails everywhere, not only in India but in other countries too. You can see that the people are discriminating the other people on the basis of their wealth. If a wealthy person, a millionaire, come to your city, you all people go there to see that person. Even the stars, if the stars come to your city, you all people go to see those people. But if a poor person requests you to help him, we always try to ignore him. It happens with us also, that we always try to ignore him. So what we are doing? We are simply discriminating the people on the basis of their wealth. That means the people, those who are wealthy, we will help those people want to live with those people, but the people, those who are poor, we don't want even to help them. In the same thing, it happens here also that when we go to malls, we do not bargain for anything. Whatever price they ask, we pay. Okay? Without saying anything, we pay that price. But when we go to that hart in Sabji Mandi, where when we go to buy the vegetables, so what we do? We start bargaining with those poor people, those who are even simply getting 1 or 2 rupees profit from selling the vegetables. We start bargaining with them. No, we will not give this much of money. You just lower the price of this item. So in this way, what we are doing? We are just discriminating. We are ready to pay to the wealthy people, but we don't want to pay to the poor people, those who is actually in need of money. We are not helping those people. So what we are doing here again, we are discriminating the people on the basis of their wealth. So our next topic is diversity and the Indian Constitution. So this is our next topic. So the Indian Constitution recognizes that India is the land of many languages, cultures and religions. So in order to protect this diversity and to show respect to India's diverse social groups, the Indian Constitution has given some fundamental rights to all the citizens of India. So let's discuss about all these fundamental rights. So the first right that is given is all Indians are equal before the law. That means law will never discriminate among the people, whether the people belong to a rich family, whether the person belongs to a poor family or belongs to any religion, he would be treated equally. Next is, every Indian is free to travel or live anywhere within the country. So all the citizens of India, they are free to go anywhere in the country and can live in any state, anywhere in the country. But it should be legal. Okay? That means they are not constructing. It should not be like that they are constructing the houses in the illegal land. Okay? In the government, on the government lands. Okay? Next is, no Indian can be exploited or forced to work. If they don't willing to work, they don't want to work, so no one can be forced them to work. Next is, every Indian has the right to follow the religion of his or her choice. So no one can force here the people to follow the religion that they like to follow. So every Indian, they are having their own choice, and according to their choice, they can follow the religion. So the next fundamental right is the fifth right. Every community has the right to promote and preserve its own language. And the last fundamental right is, a person can go to a court of law if he or she is denied any of these rights. So if person feels that he or she has not given all these rights that are already mentioned in our constitution, then he or she can go to a court of law. So this is enough for today. I have explained here about the civics chapter that is going to come in our unit test 1. So prepare well for this. In next video, we will discuss the exercises of all the 3 chapters, that means history, civics and geography. So thank you and have a nice day.